Okay, so hello everyone. So welcome to our mentoring training. So kumusta po kayo lahat? So kumusta po ba? May mga natututunan po ba kayo sa ating training? And I would really encourage everyone if you are, kung meron kayong natutunan, ano man po natutunan ninyo or meron kayong gustong i-share, don't hesitate po na i-comment sa, dun sa, i-type po dun sa ating comment section, ano, para naman po, ma-encourage din po yung iba, yung mga ibang members po natin or yung ibang mga nanonood, because you might not understand, ano, baka yung mga na-overcome nyo po ay pinagdadaanan pa lang ng iba. And any comment po, ano, anything that you can share would be a big help to everyone. Okay? So that's why, you know, this is one of the main reason na we really conduct this nightly training, because we want to help everyone. Especially na sa ganitong ganitong pandemic crisis, marami tayong mga nararanasan, ano, marami tayong mga hindi naiintindihan. We are all surprised by all these difficulties and circumstances. And for some of you, halos gusto niyo nang give up, di ba? Halos gusto niyo nang sumuko. Pero sabi nga, wala namang problema doon. It's part of life. It's normal na mapapagod ka, iiyak ka, susuko ka. Pero sabi nga, at the end of the day, like in any boxing fight, you are knocked down, but you are not knocked out. Okay? So knocked down, but not knocked out. So we are all perplexed. Yan ba ang pinagdadaanan nyo? Ano ba ibig sabihin ng perplexed? Ang ibig sabihin ng perplexed ay hindi, you are puzzled. Yung minsan nagtatanong ka, bakit ko kailangan pagdaanan itong mga sitwasyon na to? Ano ba ang kasalanan ko sa buhay? Ano ba ang ginawa ko? Pinaparusahan ba ako ng Diyos? Alam niyo, I've been hearing those things. But I don't believe on that. Because I have a very simple analogy about God and the devil. God, good. Devil, bad. Anything bad happens to you is not from God. It's of the devil. That's why, no matter what is happening to you, that's why, wag na wag po natin sasabihin na, inayaan ng Diyos na mangyari sa akin to. O bigay na, di ba minsan pagka nakakarinig ka ng mga, pag bumabagyo, sasabihin, plus nasira yung mga bahay, sasabihin nyo na, hinayaan ng Diyos na mangyari sa akin to, o binigay ng Diyos sa akin ito. Hindi po tayo bibigyan ng Diyos ng masamang bagay. The Bible is very clear, every good and perfect gift comes from above. So tatandaan po palagi natin 'yan. So we will have a right perspective in life. God, good, devil, bad. So sometimes we just don't get it. And lahat naman tayo, di ba? Life's not fair. Iniisip natin, life's not fair. We don't understand. Why do I need to experience this? But ganun talaga. Life will always be not fair. But the good news is, life's not fair, but God is always good. Amen? 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 7 to 9 says, "But we have this treasure in jars of clay, to show the surpassing power belongs to God and not to us. We are afflicted in every way." Yung tipong parang lahat na ng hirap sa mundo. Parang, di ba, mga sabi, meron mga tayo mga narinig, pasan ko ang daigdig. O di ba, parang sasabihin mo ay pinagbagsakan ka ng langit at lupa, o pinagtakluban ka ng langit at lupa. Di ba, parang lahat na ng problema sa'yo na bumagsak. But you are, even though you are afflicted in every way, but you are not crushed. Perplexed, but not driven to despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Life must go on. You just need to keep on fighting. As we keep on telling everyone, there's always light at every end of every tunnel. Second, and then we have here in verse 7, we now have this light shining in our hearts, but we ourselves are like a fragile clay jars containing this great treasure. This makes it clear that our great power is from God, not from ourselves. We are pressed on every side by troubles, but we are not crushed. We are perplexed, but not driven to despair. We are hunted down, but never abandoned by God. We get knocked down, but we are not destroyed. Diba? Kaya nga, in every boxing match, diba? Pwede, ilang bang round yun? Like si Pacquiao, pag napapanood yung lumalaban sa boxing, diba 12 rounds? Pwede ka naman talaga man-knockdown eh, in 11 rounds. Pero if you keep on going, getting up, at the end of the day, yes, you are knocked down, but on the 12th round, you are not knocked out. At sasabihin mo, nasa akin pa rin ang huling halakhak. So we are struck down, knocked down, but we are not destroyed. Amen? Isaiah 54:17 says, "But in that coming day, no weapon turns against you will succeed." Do you hear that? No weapon turned against you will succeed or will prosper. Okay, you will have a lot of enemies in life. You will have a lot of opposition. You cannot please everybody. But at the end of the day, if you know that you know that you are destined to do something great, then those people will not succeed against you. You just need to keep on fighting. You will silence every voice raised up to accuse you. Wow! Do you like that? You will silence every voice raised up to accuse you. These benefits are enjoyed by the servants of the Lord. Their vindication will come from me. I, the Lord, have spoken. So no matter what you're going through, kung naranasan mo na lahat ng hirap sa mundo, lahat ng hirap sa buhay, then you need to be thankful because your time will come. You are going to be vindicated by God. Amen? Prayer is the vaccine for worry. The vaccine has been released. This is the vaccine for anxiety. So every day of our life, you got to understand, lahat naman talaga tayo nagwo-worry. Lahat tayo umiiyak sa problema. Lahat tayo nagsasuffer. Lahat tayo are going through ups and downs. But the most important thing is we keep on praying and we keep on, kumbaga, ito ang bakuna na wala talagang side effect, di ba? Ito ang bakuna na kailangan ng bawat isa. Vaccine for worry, vaccine for anxiety. At tingin ko, kahit araw-araw tayo magpabakuna, hindi ka matatakot. Diba? Hindi ka ma-overdose dito. Philippians chapter 4 verses 6 to 7. Do not be anxious about anything. Do not worry about anything. But in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. Yun ang ibig sabihin niya na instead na mag-worry ka, iyak mo na lang lahat kay Lord. Total, sabi naman, God will never leave you. God will never forsake you. And one day you will wake up in the morning, you will really carry with you that victorious spirit. That's why God said, you are more than conqueror. Amen? And the peace of God, ayan, eto na. If you give everything to God, the peace of God which surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and your mind in Christ Jesus. So it's not whether you get knocked down, it's whether you get up. For 11 rounds, every time you are down, getting up, so that at the end of the day, you are just knocked down, but you are not knocked out. Okay? So getting knocked down in life is a given. Given na yan talaga. Wala namang successful person ang hindi naka-experience ng tremendous trouble. Getting knocked down in life is a given. Getting up and moving forward is a choice. So it's up to us. It's really up to us. Nobody can stop you from what you want in life. There's a lot of people that when they get knocked down, they stay knocked down. But there's a lot of people when they are knocked down, they keep on moving forward and they keep on getting up. Okay? Deuteronomy 34:32:4, it says here, He is the rock. His deeds are perfect. Everything He does is just and fair. Kahit nga sabihin natin na life's not fair. Yes, maybe in our eyes, but not in the eyes of God. God is a God of justice. God is the God of fairness. He is faithful. He is a faithful God who does no wrong. How just and upright He is. So storms of life don't last forever. So this is the truth of life. Storms of life don't last forever. As I always tell everyone, nothing in this world is permanent. Everything is temporary. Even problems are temporary. Worries and cares to God, for God cares for you. Sometimes, alam nyo, iniisip natin na parang pinabayaan ka na, parang sinasabi mo, nobody cares, nobody thinks about me, nobody really cares about me, para bang araw-araw na lang ang nakikita ko ay puro problema, puro hirap. But you got to understand, every day, you just need to give it to God. Give all your worries and cares to God, for God cares about you. Okay, so did you learn something from that? So I really encourage everyone, you just need to keep on listening to this mentoring training. Okay, so get back to this training presentation. If you can listen to this repeatedly every day until you is encouraged, until you convince yourself that kahit anong hirap na pinagdadaanan mo, God is about to give you the victory. So thank you so much everyone for your time. God bless everyone and continue to listen to our wellness presentation after this.